favorite Camp Shai song, and oh, maybe not our favorite, but one of the wonderful Camp Shai songs that we sing, and that is Hinei Mah Tov. So here we go. Sing along with me. First of all, can you wave if you can hear me? Okay, good. Here we go. Ready?
How great it is for brothers and sisters to hang out on this day. Hinei Mah Tov u'manayim shevet achim gam yachad. How great it is for brothers and sisters to hang out on this day. Hi-oh-oh, 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 hi-oh-oh. Hinei Mah Tov u'manayim shevet achim shevet achim gam yachad.
Nice job, everybody. You all sounded great, even though I couldn't hear you. I'm sure you sounded great. It looked like you were sounding awesome.
Thanks so much, Sam. We are now going to turn it over to our one and only Camp Shai director, Courtney Jacobson, is going to lead us in an amazing survivor activity that we can all play along with at home.
Camp Shai.
Go ahead.
We are so excited to have you here today. Thanks for joining us. Hopefully you are getting your Lego skills ready and putting this to the test. I know a lot of you have had a lot of practice at this Lego skills that we can provide for you today. So what we are going to do is you're going to have 90 seconds to build the tallest freestanding Lego structure. And when we are ready, Daniel's gonna show some of our tallest Lego structures. Okay, is everybody ready? If you're ready, let me see you cheering from your house. Okay, great. I see the Steiners are ready. Who else is ready? It looks like there's a bunch of folks that are ready. All right. Okay, all right, Camp Shai, in true survivor fashion, don't start yet. We're gonna start, and you're racing Molly. We're gonna start, ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. All right, how are we doing? Okay, I think Daniel had some very funny music for us. For our last, we have 1 minute left, guys, for your biggest Lego tower ever. All right, let's take a look. It looks like Eden's doing really, really well. Steiner sisters are crushing it Lego-wise. What's up, Becker? All right, the moss pet is busy building. The walls are busy building. Daphne and Leo are watching progress. Okay, all right, guys, we have, in fact, 10 more seconds, so let's count it down. Are you ready? We have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, hands in the air. Okay, Daniel, can you spotlight some of our tall Lego structures?
Fletcher, that's awesome.
That's the tallest Lego structure.
Who we got here? Ah, hello.
How'd we do?
All right, let's look at the deckers over here. What do we have right there? Oh my gosh, that one's huge.
Guys.
That's awesome.
Sophie and Millie, that's huge. That's like as tall as you guys.
The Rafaelis getting creative. Loving
it. All right, Rafaelis, what a tower that is.
Cora, let's see what you got. Nice.
Morgan, love that. I love this decorative patio too that you have. It's nice.
Jojo, do you got a tower?
What's up, Jojo? Look at your, oh, beautiful tower, my friend.
Nice.
Beautiful. All right, awesome. Good job, everybody. If we didn't show you, you did a great job. Thanks for playing Survivor today. Give yourselves a pat on the back.
All right, thanks, Courtney. That was awesome. Thanks for playing along, everybody. We're going to move on to an awesome extra special guest here to help us. Our friend, our one and only Jobie, is here to help us read a story. I just got to find her real quick. Did we lose her? There we go. And I'll unmute you, Jobie, if you want to say hello in just a second. There we go.
Hi, friends.
Jobie, can you tell us a little bit about the story you're reading?
Yeah, so it's called The Missing Piece. I have not read it yet. I've just kind of seen it. I'm excited to read it with all of you guys and find out what The Missing Piece is about. All right, is everybody ready? All right. The Missing Piece by Shel Silverstein. Oh, Daniel, it's not letting me control it.
Oh, no. I'll get you reading for a second.
All right. It was a missing piece, and it was happy, and it was not happy. So it set off in search of its missing piece.
I think we went too far. Okay, there we go.
As it rolled and sang the song, oh, I'm looking for my missing piece. I'm looking for my missing piece. Hi-dee-ho, here I go. I'm looking for my missing piece. So it set off in search.
Oh. There we go.
Sometimes it baked in the sun. But then the cool rain would come down. And sometimes it was frozen by the snow, but the sun would come and warm it again. And because it was a missing piece, it could not roll very fast. So it stopped to talk to a worm or smell a flower. And sometimes it would pass a beetle. And sometimes the beetle would pass it. And this was the best time of all. And on it went over oceans. Oh, I'm looking for my missing piece over land and overseas. So grease my knees and fleece my... over land and overseas. So grease my knees and fleece my bees. I'm looking for my missing piece. Through swamps and jungles, up mountains, and down mountains. Until one day, lo and behold, I found my missing piece. It sang, I found my missing piece, so grease my knees and fleece my bees. Wait a minute, said the missing piece. Before you go greasing your knees or fleecing your bees, I am not your missing piece. I am my own piece. And even if I was somebody's missing piece, I don't think I would be yours. Oh, it said sadly, I'm sorry to have bothered you, and rolled down. It found another piece. But it was too small. And this one was too big. And this one, a little too sharp. And this one was too square. One time it seemed you have found the perfect piece. But it didn't hold it again, it didn't hold it tightly enough and lost it. Another time it held too tightly and it broke.
Bummer.
So on and on it rolled, having adventures, falling into holes, and bumping into stone walls. And one day it came upon another piece that seemed just right. Hi, it said. Hi, said the piece. Are you anybody else's missing piece? Not that I know of. Well, maybe you want to be your own piece. I can be someone's and still be mine. Well, maybe you don't want to be mine. Maybe I do. Maybe we won't fit. Well, it fit. It fit perfectly. At last, at last. And away it rolled, and because it was now complete, it rolled faster and faster, faster than it ever rolled before. So fast it could not stop to talk to a worm or smell a flower. Too fast for a butterfly to land. But it could sing its happy song. At last it could sing, I found my missing piece. And it began to sing, I found my missing geese, ooh, from my missing breeze. So grease my knees and bleeze my drees, ooh, frown, oh, wow. That was complete. It could not sing at all. It's a confusing song. Aha, I thought, so that's how it is. He stopped. So it stopped rolling and the and it set the piece down gently. And it slowly rolled away. And as it rolled, it softly sang, oh, I'm looking for my missing piece. I'm looking for my missing piece. Hi-dee-hee-ho, here I go. I'm looking for my missing piece. The end. Thank you.
Thanks, Jobie. Thanks so much for reading.
That was of course. Excellent.
That's The Missing Piece by Shel Silverstein. We are now, we're going to actually jump to a song real quick. So I have some time to get set up for our awesome science experiment. If Molly could jump up here, we're going to get her going with an awesome song. Having trouble finding Molly though. There she is.
All right. Wave your whole body if you can hear me. Amazing. Okay, my friends, this is a Camp Shai classic and a repeat after me song. So, are you ready? Okay. You.
Ukulele.
You. Ukulele.
A teeny tiny tomato.
A teeny tiny tomato.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
My pants are still too tight.
My pants are still too tight.
Ukulele.
Ukulele.
A teeny tiny tomato.
A teeny tiny tomato.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
My pants are still too tight.
My pants are still too tight.
Ukulele.
Ukulele.
A teeny tiny tomato.
A teeny tiny tomato.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
My pants are still too tight.
My pants are still too tight.
Okay. That was pretty good.
Should I stretch?
We should stretch. Stretch your arms. Maybe get like your quad in there. Put your legs up to the ceiling. Wiggle your whole body so you know you're ready. Okay. Let me see some thumbs up. Are you guys ready? All right. Ukulele.
Ukulele.
A teeny tiny tomato.
A teeny tiny tomato.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
Your mother drives a Chevy.
My pants are still too tight.
My pants are still too tight.
Woo! Good job, everyone. So proud of you.
Thanks, Molly, and special guest. That was excellent. Thanks so much for singing along with us, Camp Shai. I hope you had fun with that. We're going to move on to our STEM activity for the week. So if you have a few things with you, you're going to need a glass of water. Maybe not as much as I have, but you'll need some ice cubes. You can put them in the glass if you want. And some regular old salt. I took mine out of this big thing of salt because I don't have a salt shaker. But if you got a salt shaker, that's totally fine too. So hopefully you have all those things. If you don't, that's okay. You can do this later. You can watch for now. That's totally, totally fine. But again, it's time to do some science. So if you're here last week, you might know that we like to do science at Camp Shai in a very specific way, and we need some specific things to do science. So I'm going to get a couple of things that help me do science. My first thing is my science hat. See that? You can tell it's my science hat because it says science on it. And, you know, when you're doing science, you also really want to be super, super safe, even though nothing here at all is dangerous. It's just good practice. Get yourself in the mindset of doing things the right way. So we're going to wear our safety science goggles. Got it. Put back on our science hat. Make sure we're in the right mind frame. Okay, here we go. Cool. So science. There's always a question. We want to ask a question. Today's, I was thinking about skiing, how much I miss skiing, and then I was thinking about how driving is usually kind of scary, and it's like, oh, the roads are really slick and they're icy, but what do you do? Oh, they put salt down, but like, how does that work? Why do they put salt on the roads when it's icy? So I put my science hat on, sat down, and did a little research, and I started thinking a little bit about why we put salt on the roads. So let's rewind a little bit, and let's think about how water works. Water actually comes in three different forms. We call them stages of matter. We can look at a diagram, which is what we use when we use science. We can look at a diagram and think about the different types of water. There's liquid water, which we just call water. There's solid water, which we call ice, which is this stuff. And then there's gas, steam. We're not really going to talk about that today, but we're going to talk about these two a lot. There's liquid and the solid, water and ice. Cool. Stages of matter. Got that? Okay. So it turns out that every kind of substance, everything that we have, it can go from a liquid to a solid. what is it called when you take water and turn it into ice? Does anybody know how to say it really loud? Tell your friends, tell your family in the room. You're right. It's called freezing. So that exact moment when things go from a liquid to a solid is called a freezing point, from a liquid to a solid. So maybe some, if you want to put it in the chat, does anybody know what the temperature is, the freezing point of water? Say it to yourself, guess, put it in the chat if you want. Does anybody know what the degree measurement is when it goes from, when water goes from a liquid to a solid? Okay, yeah. Sophie said 32 degrees. That's 100% correct in Fahrenheit. And the Siegel family, I'm assuming that's Ariella and Elizabeth, they said 0 degrees. Yeah, you're right too. That's 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. That is the freezing point of water. So we know the freezing point, we know stages of matter. Great. So now let's look at salt. We got some salt here in my little bowl. Is salt a liquid or a solid? What do we think? Kind of pours around. If you look close enough, it's actually a solid. So I guess you could say it's technically already frozen, but it's frozen at room temperature, which ice isn't frozen at room temperature. My ice is starting to melt and kind of make a mess on my desk. So we have a solid at room temperature, not a solid at room temperature, huh? So to demonstrate this, we're gonna start our little demonstration now. If you've got your water in front of you and you got your ice, this is what you're gonna do. You're gonna put your ice in your water, a couple cubes. I don't know if you can see what's going on there. Okay, cool, now you can see. A couple cubes of ice. Make sure there's some room in there for them. These ones are really big, so there's not a lot of room in my water glass. Hopefully I can make it work. All right, and we're gonna show how salt makes water and ice melt a little bit. And we're gonna pick up our ice cube with some string. So what you're gonna do now is you're gonna take your string and you can use whatever string you got available. And you're gonna put it right on top of your ice cubes or cube if you can. Mine is not cooperating so well, but we'll keep trying to get it to work. And then very carefully, you're gonna take some of that salt that you have with you and you're gonna put it right on top. I'm gonna use a different string. This string's not working. I have a smaller piece of string. You're gonna put it right on top where that string is touching that ice cube. Okay, you can see me kind of sprinkling it on there. There it is, right on top of that ice cube where that string is. In order for this to work, we've gotta wait a little bit because there kind of has to be some reaction between the salt and the ice and the water. But while we're waiting, don't worry. I've got some water-based jokes for you. And maybe I can have my friends Molly or Courtney maybe answer some of these jokes for me. I'll unmute them and maybe they can say some funny things.
All right, fire away.
All right, here we go. Let me see here. Okay, what runs but never walks?
What runs but never walks?
A river.
Yes, a river runs, but it doesn't walk.
Yes.
Hey, Molly, what kind of beds do mermaids sleep on?
Ooh, water beds.
Water beds, correct. You got it.
Ugh. Give me my graduate degree now.
Yep.
I'm done.
Hey, Courtney. Oh, she muted herself. Okay. Well, Molly, what's a king's favorite type of precipitation?
King's favorite type of precipitation. Hail. Hail the king.
Correct. Hail the king. Yes.
Ooh, good one, Daniel.
Hey, Molly.
Yeah.
Why do sharks only swim in salt water?
Because only swim in salt water. Because they, I don't know, because something with their teeth, maybe. Because
if they swam in pepper water, they'd be sneezing all the time.
Oh. That was my next guess.
Did you ever hear about the ice cube's escape from the freezer?
No, I did not.
It wasn't a very well thought out plan.
Oh, no. Wow, science, Daniel.
Left a lot of puddle.
Yeah.
Wasn't it clean?
A friend of mine actually made these ice cubes for me earlier. You could say they were doing me a solid. All right, Camp Shai. Let's see if it's been enough time of me telling really bad jokes and lagging for our chemical reaction to occur. The idea here is that because salt is a higher freezing point in temperature, it's going to make some of that water on the top of that ice cube melt a little bit. So we're going to see if I can pick up this ice cube just using the string that I put on top of the ice cube. Here we go. Here's the magic moment. Put the string. Oh, mine didn't stick. Bummer. We didn't have quite enough time, but I encourage you to try it on your own at home. Again, you're gonna put the string on top of the ice cube like this one. You're gonna sprinkle some salt right on top of that string, and you're gonna let it sit for a while. Maybe I'll let mine sit, and at the end of the video, we can check it out. But for now, I'll explain to you a little bit how that works.
So Daniel, really fast, it looks like a couple people got it.
Oh my gosh, you got it. I see Fletcher Kaplan, I'm gonna spotlight you. Can you show me your ice cube? Show it to us, pick it up in front of the camera if you can. I like your goggles, by the way, that's excellent. Yeah, nice, dude.
It looked right. Like JoJo got it.
JoJo, let me see you. Yeah, good job, JoJo. Good work.
Well done.
Wait, that's Fiona. That's not JoJo.
Got it?
That's JoJo. Did you get it?
Miles got it.
Oh, let's see. It looks like Eden got it too. Good job.
Good job, Eden.
Gosh,
well
you guys
done.
Are better scientists than me. Oh, and I think we got some over here too. Good job.
Good job, Sophie and Billy.
Thanks for reminding me to look.
Decker Power. Good job, guys.
Gosh, so fun. Okay. Well, thanks for sharing all of those. If you did it or you do it later, please send us a picture or a video. We love to see those kinds of things. It's super fun. So thanks for playing along and doing some STEM activity. If you want to know how it works, real quick, this is the ice cube that we have here. The salt causes it to melt and make a little layer of water right on top. And then that's where our string sits. And then the ice cube freezes that little layer of water again. And that's how our string gets stuck. It's so cool. So thanks for doing STEM with us. Thanks for putting your science hat on. I love the goggles. I love seeing all the silliness. And again, if you want to send us some pictures, that's great. Moving right along, I can take off my science hat now, I guess. I've heard that Sam has another song for us. Is that true, Sam? Okay, he's getting ready. Here we go.
You know, Daniel, I believe it is true, and I actually have my guitar right here, so.
Is there someone else helping you with the song, maybe?
I think Maddie Wells wants to help me with the song. Does Maddie want to help me with the song?
I would love to help you with the song.
Oh, great. Well, I think y'all know this one, but if you don't, it's my favorite fruit. Whenever ready, Maddie.
So I was at this party the other night and I met this really funny guy. He was tall and silly. He had on green pants. But he was like telling me this story and it was like blah, blah, blah. And I was like, mm-hmm.
Here we go. I'm gonna go home and I'm gonna eat some grapes. La, 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 grapes. La, 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 grapes. La, 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 grapes. So I told him, I said, I bet you're really nice. I bet your story's really interesting, but I don't want to hear it twice, because I'm starving. Now, I'm going to go home, and I'm going to eat some grapes, la 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 grapes, la 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 grapes, la 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 grapes. I want to go home, go home.
So I was heading home, but it was such a beautiful day, and I thought, maybe I better stop at the swimming pool. And I was all swimming and underwater and blah, blah, blah. But I got water up my nose, and it was not good. And I was like, forget this.
I'm gonna go home and I'm gonna eat some grapes. La 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 grapes. La 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 grapes. La 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 grapes. I wanna go home, go home. I wanna go home, go home. I wanna go home, go home. La 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 la.
I'm gonna go eat some grapes right now. Excuse me. See you guys later.
Amazing. That's one of our favorite songs. Thanks so much for dancing and singing along, everybody. And now I'm gonna turn it over to Molly again, because Molly has some of our me dope for the week for some of our campers that have been doing awesome around the home and helping out with their siblings and doing their schoolwork and things like that. Just living up to all those Camp Shai, you dope, those Camp Shai values. I'll do my best to highlight everybody. Sometimes it's kind of hard to find everybody, so I'm sorry if I can't find you, but we're going to do our best here.
All right. And we have CJ more than 6 feet behind me to socially distantly cheer you all on. So let's start with Miss Cora Morgan. Hello, Cora. Cora exhibited Hesed kindness this week because she was super patient with her little brother and has gone out of her way to include him in all of her activities. Great job, Cora. We're so proud of you. Next, I would love to recognize JoJo, JoJo Schwartz. JoJo, you have been an exemplar. You have been a great example of kindness with your little brother, Judah. Great job, JoJo. That's awesome. Next, I would love to go to Rylan. Where's Miss Rylan Cohn? Hi, Rylan. Rylan, you have been nominated for Kahila Community. Rylan has been making sidewalk art to spread joy to the neighborhood as well as to thank the delivery people. She's also been making animal cards for her aunts and uncles and cousins and grandparents. And it lifts their spirits and makes them feel really, really good. So thank you so much, Rylan. That's awesome. I would love to go to the Bellstocks next. Silas gets Kahila because he is participating in his classes and he makes his family smile with silliness and sweet hugs. And Mr. Harrison, hi Harrison. He is working super, super hard at school and helping his family out. He gets a dinner table ready and he reaches snacks for his little brother Silas, which is so lovely. Great job. Next, Tova and Gila Noblock. There they are. They have been very caring towards one another and being very, very good sisters. And then where's Miss Fiona? Fiona Dwyer. Fiona has shown a lot of kindness this week. Great job, Fiona. And then we got a couple more in the chat. Miss Eden, wherever Miss Eden Dolberg is, she has been doing an awesome job at home. Very, very great news. And then the Steiner sisters, Julie has been doing her work, and also they advocated for themselves, showing good kavod and respect for themselves. We also want to give a special shout out to Carol, wherever Carol is in the video, Miss Courtney's mom, for showing amazing kahila, for participating and being wonderful. And another special shout out to Maddie, Jobie, and Sam for jumping in and reading and singing and just really making our Shai community come alive today. So Daniel, oh wait, and then one more, Sophie and Millie. And they showed a lot of kindness today and all week by playing together and being great siblings. So thank you all for continuing the Camp Shai Midote. We know it's not always easy, but it sounds like you are all the best representatives of all the things we think are important, like kindness and community and sportsmanship and respect. So thank you so, so much.
Thanks, Molly, and thanks for all of our Mido receivers for doing such awesome job. Keep it up. If you didn't get one this week, that's okay. Keep doing the good things that you're doing that we know you're doing at home. and send those in for your parents, for your friends. And thank you for being such great members of our community. Last thing before we sign off, I just want to wish some happy birthdays to some Camp Shai campers for this week and staff. Our Aunt Emma Piercy, Charlie Plus' birthday, Ariella Kojab, Grayson Tashiro, Jack Roberts, Lily Shaffrin, and Gwen Warren. Happy birthday to all of you. Thanks so much for being part of Camp Shai. And last thing before we go, and I'll open up the mic and let everybody say hello to each other and chat for a little bit. We have an art project at the JCC that we would love for your help with. We're asking people to submit a creative version of the Israeli flag, whatever that means to you. You can make it out of cool things around your house. You can maybe decorate something in your house that looked like an Israeli flag. Whatever you want to do to incorporate an Israeli flag, we're doing that because Israel Independence Day is next week, and it's a really cool and fun holiday. And that's really all the reminders we have for you. Join us next week. Look out for content on our JCC Camp Shai Facebook page for fun things to do at home. And thanks so much for joining us. Have a great week, everybody.